Hello friends, welcome. I am M. Varshini of 11th. Now I am going to take a seminar on a topic, phylum Arthropoda.
In Greek, orthos means jointed, pods means feet. Arthropoda means jointed feet. Arthropoda is the largest phylum of kingdom Animalia and it includes the largest class called Insecta. Here, the total number of species ranges from 2 to 10 million. Arthropodas are bilaterally symmetrical, segmented, triploblastic and zygocoelomate animals with organ system grade of organization. Bilaterally symmetrical means the body can be divided into two identical halves. Segmented means the body of an organism is divided into three parts, namely head, thorax and abdomen. And triploblastic means the organism having three germinal layers, namely endoderm, ectoderm and mesoderm. And these organisms are zygocoelomates because in these animals the body cavity is formed by splitting of mesoderms. With they also have organ system made of body organization. Arthropods have jointed appendages. Jointed appendages means growth from the body of an organism having joints in it, which are used for locomotion, that means to move from one place to another, feeding and or sensory in function. Body is covered by chitinous exoskeleton. Chitinous exoskeleton means the exoskeleton which is formed of chitin, which helps for protection and to prevent water loss. It shed off periodically by a process called molting or ecdysis. Molting or ecdysis is the shedding of the exoskeleton, typically to let the organism to grow. The body consists of head, thorax and abdomen and also a body cavity called hemocoel. Respiratory organs such as gills, book gills, book lungs and trachea are also present. Circulatory system is of open type, in which the blood remains filled in the tissue spaces due to the absence of blood capillaries. Sensory organs like antennae, eyes, which are both compound and simple, and statocyst, which act as an organ of balance or balanced sensory receptor, are also present in arthropods. And excretion takes place through Malpighian tubules, green gland, coccal glands, etc. Arthropods are mostly dioecious or oviparous. Dioecious means having male reproductive organ in one individual and female in another. An oviparous or the organism that lay eggs. And here the fertilization is usually internal. Internal fertilization is the union of male and female gametes inside the female body during sexual reproduction. Development may be direct or indirect. Direct development does not involve free living larval stage, whereas indirect development involves larval stage. Here, the larval stage means stage in the development of many animals occurring after birth and before the adult form is reached. And the life history includes many larval stages followed by metamorphosis. First, it is in the form of egg, then first larval stage, second larval stage, third larval stage, pupa, and at last it transforms into adult. And here the metamorphosis means changes in the form that occurs as an insect approaches adulthood. This is the image of the life cycle of Arthropoda. Now we can see some of the examples of Arthropoda. Limulus, king crab, a living fossil. Palamnes, scorpion. Eupagaris, hermit crab. Apis, honeybee. Musca, housefly. Some arthropods are vectors. Vectors are the organisms that carry and transmit disease-causing organism from one host to another. Example, Anopheles, Culex, and AIDS. An economically important insect such as Apis honeybee, Bombyx silkworm, Lucifer lac insects. And at last, Locusta locust. It is known as gregarious pest because it attack on crop fields and obtain food from there and live their life. Thank you.